Harlem is a place where you learn to grow up very quickly. You're very independent at a young age. You're probably outside in your neighborhood or at your school or after school more than in your own household, and you spend time with friends more than you spend time with your family. Around the age of 15, I found myself joining a gang. And around 16, 17 years old, my school schedule to me, but it basically started to slow down. I stopped going to school, really. I started hanging with my friends. And that seemed pretty cool for a while, but then I wound up not graduating. It kind of hit me. So I took it heavy in the gang. And until I got a phone call one night, a scary phone call, basically saying that my brother and a couple of my friends had got jumped really badly. Both of my brother's hands were broken with a brick, and he got hit in the head with a pipe. He was in a coma for about 3 days. And when he woke up, he really didn't recognize anyone. He didn't know who I was. He didn't know who basically anyone was. And that really hurt. And more than that hurting, it was a moment that woke me up. I seen
I met Mr. Wendell Wilson out here right on the streets of Harlem. I was looking to engage the community, do what we know to do in Young Life, and do some contact work in the neighborhood. And I had met a friend of his who was talking about a bunch of his friends. And so I saw them walking down the block, showed up, said, "Hey, you guys want some pizza? I'm showing a documentary called Men and Boys." And I asked them to come inside and hang out, got to know them.
So I met Aswan actually in the funniest way ever. Me and one of my friends were actually walking towards a church in my community, and he's standing outside inviting people in for a movie and pizza and just to hang out. So we decided to wind up keeping in contact with him. He took us out to Applebee's, just a couple of places. We got to know each other. Then a few weeks after, he took us on a trip to one of the Young Life camps in North Bay. And I didn't know why I was going. On the way there, I was looking forward to going somewhere.
Paid it in. And so as we continued to walk alongside them, I invited them to this opportunity to be a leader. So there was a leadership camp happening in North Bay, and I got the okay from the supervisors, from the great Paul Cody, that it'd be okay to bring somebody that we were looking to disciple. And so I brought Wendell and his friends down. We got a great time to talk. We had a great time to talk, and we stayed in the room together.
And on the way home, he was just saying spark. He was talking about the spark, and I'm like,
"Who was talking about that?"
Aswan was talking about the spark. So I'm like, "What is the spark?" He's like, "He's spark plug, spark showing people a real kingdom." I'm like, "Oh, I get it. You know, seeing life in a different way, and living it out and." Showing other people that there is a better way to live. And I finally got the Christ thing, or this thing we call Christ. And on that ride back, I just was like, this is something I definitely want to try. I want to give my life to Christ. My relationship with Christ is growing every single day, and just waking up in the morning and appreciating the life he's given me, to fellowship, changing my surroundings and the people I've that I hang out with. I'm in my first year of training to be a wildlife leader, and to giving back and just sharing my story with others. And I know that there's definitely young males out there who are just like me at my age that just maybe need a little guidance or someone to talk to. And I would love to be that person, and I would love to introduce Christ into their life. He's the greatest gift you could give. This is Aswan Morris. Praise him. And this is my young life leader.
The fact that he loved to play basketball, I don't know if he'll admit this, but we beat him 11 straight games, and that's on camera, so just make sure you know he did not win a game down there against me.